Good morning and welcome to the Take Your Life Back Today show. My name is Ralf Friedrichs. I'm an addiction recovery coach, a life coach, and the host of this show, the Take Your Life Back Today show. I want to talk about some questions about going to heaven or what it's like to be in heaven. And one question that was sent in to me was, doesn't everyone go to heaven? I'm going to read this to you. So unfortunately, not everyone does go to heaven. This might sound very harsh, but it is true. Man didn't make up this rule. God made up this rule. The Father in heaven isn't concerned with being politically correct. He is concerned with bringing each and every human into the right relationship with him through his Son, Jesus Christ. God has provided a specific plan with, and a clear explanation, my friends, through his word, the Bible. God would love to have everyone join him in heaven, but in order to gain entrance to the eternal rest with God in heaven, we must believe that Jesus is the Son of God. We need to repent our sins and confess to the Lord Jesus of our lives. God is very clear that there are no other gods above him and no other paths to eternity. In fact, Christianity is the only religion that promises salvation from sin to eternity in heaven with God. God the Father, one third of the Trinity, is very clear that Jesus, the Son of God, the second part of the Trinity, provided the sacrifice for mankind necessary to receive relationship with God. The Holy Spirit, the third part of Trinity, guides us to comfort us as we remain on earth awaiting heaven. So the five questions about going to heaven is, what happens to us in the first minute after we die? The Bible certainly doesn't indicate what when we die, what immediately happens, we do enter the presence of God where we belong with Christ. From our earthly point of view, death looks somewhat like sleep, but not for God's point of view. Paul declared, "We are confident of eternal life. I say that we prefer to be away from the body and at home with the Lord." 2 Corinthians 5:8. Elsewhere, he wrote, "Morning, I desire to be part and be with Christ, which is the better by far." Philippians 1:23. So to take away from the question, what happens to us when we first, in the first minute after you die, death is not to be feared or dreaded if you are a follower of Christ. When we die, those who have accepted Christ will immediately enter God's presence. We will receive new bodies that do not age and enjoy eternal life. Question number two was, will we recognize our loved ones in heaven? Will they recognize us? Perhaps you're thinking of Isaiah 65:17. "Behold, I will create new heavens and a new earth. The former things will not be remembered, nor will they come to mind." But the verse has nothing to do with whether or not we will be reunited with our loved ones. Our loved ones in heaven, as we know, are also with Christ if they repented. Instead, it gives us a great promise. Someday, all the sins and pains and failures of this world will be over and we will be with Christ forever. So the takeaway from this question was, will we recognize loved ones in heaven? Is, we do not need to worry about being separated from our loved ones in heaven because our loved ones are within our hearts. Question number three is, when we get to heaven, will we know what's happening on earth? The Bible doesn't answer all our questions about heaven, that I can promise you. And we don't know exactly how much knowledge those in heaven have about what happens here on earth. The Bible does say that we are surrounded by a great cloud of witness. Let me just move this over. Of those who have already entered and are there waiting for us. It is very clear. I should say it's not very clear. If it means that they are able to observe our lives in Hebrews 12:1. The takeaway from that is we don't know everything there is to know about heaven because we have not been there. We have not been there, my friends. But if we can't see what's happening on earth, we will see past the pain, the sadness, because we are able to see the heavenly perspective as God does. Number four, when we die, does an angel guide us to heaven? Yes, the Bible indicates that when a believer dies, the angels will escort them safely to heaven. The takeaway from that question is, angels do God's work, including escorting believers to heaven. We know this from the scripture. Our guardian angels protects us from Satan. And they will guide us to heaven. They will make sure that we get to where we deservedly go because we believed in God. And the last question is, will there be animals in heaven? My friends, heaven will be a place of perfect happiness for us, and we will need animals around us to make our happiness complete. Then you can be sure that God will have them there. The takeaway is, heaven will include everything we need. We cannot even imagine the joy that we will have and experience when we are in the presence of our God. We are finally at home with the Lord. Friends, the questions about heaven are so direct and so self-explanatory. But not everybody does go to heaven. In order to go to heaven, you need to repent. You need to ask God in your life. And there's no better way and no better time than to start today. Remember that God so loved the world that he gave his only son. How many of you parents and grandparents out there would give up your children, your grandchildren, for the sake of other people? Well, God did that. For the sake of human mankind, he gave his only son to die for your sins. Call me at 844-405-HELP. We can help each other take our lives back. And remember this, that the power of prayer is so strong that eventually, in God's time, every prayer will be answered. Don't expect to pray and have answers right away. But if you faithfully pray each and every day, and you faithfully live a life according to the Bible, you, my friends, will also go to heaven. And I will see you there then one day. 844-405-HELP. Let us help each other take our lives back, and may God bless you.